The Monday after a Browns tie, Mary Kay, not a loss, not a win, a tie. And really the news of the day is Emmanuel Ogba suffering an injury, an ankle injury, and he's going to miss some time. It's significant because the Browns were obviously counting very heavily on Ogba to play opposite of Myles Garrett, and now they're going to be without him for a little while.
Yeah, this is what they talked about all offseason. Myles was so excited to be back with E-Man, and we know how Myles Garrett suffered from a high ankle sprain last year, and it really set him back. He missed 4 games, and it hampered him throughout the whole season. So hopefully for the Browns, this one is not as bad as that, and he won't be out that long, because that's a huge hit. These two guys were supposed to be working in concert. It was one of the reasons they really considered being able to draft Denzel Ward and not a Bradley Chubb and things of that nature.
So the Browns will have to work around that. Chris Smith will get some more playing time. Also, Zettel, the player that they claimed from Detroit last week, will get an opportunity as well. Now, the other big story today, Josh Gordon started the game yesterday after weeks of Hugh Jackson saying he wasn't going to start. Jackson again attributed to a miscommunication with the package the Browns had on the field to start the game.
Yeah, and you know what? I think maybe more might be being made of this than what it deserves. Basically, there was a miscommunication. Todd Haley did not realize how important it was, apparently, for Hugh Jackson not to have Josh Gordon out there on the first play. He basically gave us a soliloquy last Wednesday about why that wasn't going to happen, and it had everything to do with the fact that other receivers have been here this whole time, and they deserved that nod. So it was one play in a sort of jumbo formation. Josh split wide, 3 tight ends on the other side, and he came right out after that. I'm sure there was a little bit of a discussion, and these guys've worked it out, they've had it out over this, and it's over.
And if you're one of those people out there hoping that maybe Hugh Jackson would consider switching quarterbacks to Baker Mayfield, it doesn't sound like he's ready to do that anytime soon. He again just committed to Tyrod Taylor after a game when Taylor struggled, but Jackson really kind of put all of that on the offensive unit as a whole.
Yeah, he really took any of the blame off of Tyrod's shoulders and basically just talked about protection and receivers needing to get open and all the different things that just didn't go well on that offense yesterday. And obviously, it is a work in progress. That was the first time they had ever played together. First time that Josh Gordon and Tyrod Taylor had been out on the field together. They never played together in preseason. First time for Desmond Harrison, Chris Hubbard, Todd Haley calling the plays. So it was all new, and now I think they have to just get it together from here.
And lastly, Desmond Harrison made his debut at left tackle on Sunday. I rewatched the game a little bit today, and it doesn't seem quite as bad as initially thought, but there were still some struggles there. But Jackson not ready to give up on Harrison yet.
No, not at all. In fact, he's gotten some really good reviews for basically settling down in the second half. Even Joe Thomas was on the Cleveland Browns radio today just talking about that very thing, about how he believes he can be the future of left tackle, and how he really came around in the second half of that game. So he is the left tackle for now. We'll see how it goes.
It will be on to New Orleans after today. The Browns will start getting ready for the Saints. We'll have full coverage of yesterday's game, everything from today, and of course, all the lead up to the Saints game at cleveland.com/Browns.